So, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Today we are discussing about hospital pharmacy supplies procurement. So today's topic is hospital pharmacy supplies procurement. Mostly it is related with the procurement in public hospital, the government hospitals. What they are going to purchase, what they procure, mostly what they have to do. The basic thing is that they purchase drug and medicines, they purchase medical equipment, other supplies, vaccine, sera, laboratory, so and so they have to purchase. So we'll go one by one according to that. So because in a hospital, there's so many things has to purchase, the medical equipment they are going to purchase, disposable they have to purchase, operation theater equipment they are going to purchase. So this is a vast subject of procurement. So what is the content of this lecture is the hospital medical supplies, national hospital formulary. Then we learn about surgical and disposable articles, laboratory chemicals and diagnostics, X-ray films, MRI films, CT scan films, surgical instruments, medical gases. So we learn about the after that procurement rules, procurement methods, risk purchase. So hospital medical procurements, what they contains? They have, I told you earlier, that drugs and medicines, surgical disposable articles, surgical instruments, laboratory reagents, chemicals, glassware, diagnostic kits, laboratory equipments, X-ray films, biomedical equipment, medical gases, etc., etc., so on there. So first basic is that the pharmacist is mostly concerned with all these things. Mostly he has to look after these, because these all has to be procured and placed and stocked and stored in their main warehouse. So drug and medicines, surgical instruments, laboratory reagents, diagnostic kits, whatever. So what's a national hospital formulary? Now mostly the drug medicines are procured and public hospitals are based upon National Provincial Hospital Formula. What happens that the WHO have introduced a essential medicine list. You know that there are thousands of molecules of various medicines are available. You cannot purchase all molecules. Now what happens that WHO has introduced a essential medicine list. According to that, because these are the basic medicine which must be available in a big hospitals. So they have more, I think there are more than 400 or 500 molecules are available with different dosage forms. So on the basis of that, federal or provincial hospital formulary are prepared. What they prepare? National or provincial hospital formulary. According to that, they have to purchase these drug and medicine, whatever they require. Now, what the composition of national hospital formulary is there, or provincial hospital formulary, you know about these categories of drugs, anesthetics. Anesthetics drugs, they are composition of, they may contain general anesthetics, anesthetic gases, and local anesthetics. Then there another category of drug is analgesics, antipyretics, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, medicine used to treat gout and disease modifying agent in rheumatoid disorders, DMARDs. Then they go for opioid analgesics. Then they go for anti-allergies and medicine used in anaphylaxis. The another category there, antidotes and other substances used when there is a poisons. The for poison you have must have antidotes. Then they have anti-infective medicines which apply against infections. Then there is a ant helminths or parasites, they have this category of drug also. Then there is a antibacterials, drugs which apply against bacterials. Then they go for anti-leprosy medicines. Then there is also category of anti-tuberculosis medicines, anti-convulsant, anti-epileptic drugs. So there are so many categories also found. Antifungal medicines, antiviral medicines. They have anti-retroviral medicines. Then there is a nucleoside or nucleotides, reverse transcriptase inhibitors. There is also a category of this. Protease inhibitors. There's. You are well aware of these categories of medicine and their indications. So these all has to be procured. So this is all fall under the national or provincial hospital formulary. You can check this and national medicine list in net. I think the last time they have upgraded in 2018. You can find out that national medicine. Medicine from National Hospital Formulary or National Essential National Medicine. EML is it. Then you have surgical and disposable article. In this category, you have two type of surgicals. One is reusable surgical instruments, another is disposable surgical items. One is reusable. This can be, as I've told you in your first or second lecture, sterilization. The instruments which can be reusable, they can go for sterilization in that hospital system. Reusable surgical instruments. And the other is disposable surgical instruments. And reusable instruments, you can have shears, surgical cutters, you have medical devices, hard metals such as stainless steel or any other high grade metal. So these are reusable. In disposable surgical equipment of disposable surgical equipment is stitch cutters, surgical blades, surgical suture needles, ethicon sutures, vitrical mesh, disposable syringes, blood transfusion set, forceps. These instruments help in prevention of infection and may related disease, but they are also cheaper in cost as well. So once they are used, then they have discarded. So you can see out in this picture or this. This is an OT light. As you can see, these are the reusable. These are scissors, whatever it is, the reusable. And another, these are disposable. So you can see these two type of instruments. One is reusable. They can be sterilized. And another one, disposable. Once they are used, then they have to be discarded. They have to be, so you can have you can see the both pictures, reusable surgical and disposable surgicals. And further, because in tertiary care hospital quaternary, they are secondary care, they have biomedical equipments. The big medical equipments are also known as biomedical equipment. What they have equipments? Anesthesia machines is there, autoclave, sterilizers, centrifuge, defibrillators, monitors, dermatomes, diagnostic ultrasound with probes, EKG recorders, electrosurgical unit, endoscopic equipments, exam light, fetal Doppler, fetal monitor, humidifier, infant warmers, infant incubators, lab equipment, and another. Still a list have contain more than that one. So these are big, are larger equipments. So these are known as biomedical equipments. Then further, because there is a pathology lab, mostly in tertiary care or quaternary care, they have their own pathological labs. Because without pathology labs, they cannot run a hospital. So they have laboratory, chemicals and diagnostics. So medical facilities have numerous suited laboratory operations. These in-house labs perform a variety of functions that commonly include, not limited to research. They have chemistry labs, hematology labs, pathology labs, histology labs, microbiology, and immunodiagnostics. So these are found in the laboratory chemical test. So you can see on one side various chemicals and various other types of lab commodities. You may have seen in your practical rooms, in chemistry you use various type of chemicals. Similarly, in laboratory you have to use various type of chemicals, and nowadays mostly very kits are available. According to that, they can diagnose whatever according to that need of the patients. They use these type of chemical kits over there. You can these various solutions which are applied in a lab. Now X-ray. Who has invented of the Röntgen? He has invented the X-ray. Mostly X-ray films, and nowadays CT scan films, MRI films are major part of that. Also, so the X-ray films are also procured. You can see the Röntgen. He has invented the X-ray card. Now there are so many types of diagnostics are available. You can go for CT scan, MRI. Then there is a PET scan is now available for positive emission scan. The PET scan is available. The most of now they are digitals. Mostly they can be shown in the screens, but they are also supported by various films. Regarding to that film, a physician doctor can examine on the basis of that X-ray films or whatever he can see over there. Now you have mostly when you have visited big hospital, you can see a various type of the cylinders are also applied. Whereas you can see nowadays in COVID, mostly people are going for asking for oxygen cylinders. The various type of gases are also procured in hospitals. So these cylinders have various type of coding colors. If you see an oxygen cylinder, it has a white colors. Carbon dioxide has gray. Nitric oxide has blue. Cyclopropane has orange. Helium has brown. Ethylene red have red. Carbon dioxide have gray or green, whatever. Helium brown or green. Nitrogen have black. Simple air has yellow. Nitrogen. So these are the coding of various gases. Because these gases are very essential in a hospital, in running a hospital over there. Because sometimes the patient could not breathe, so he need oxygen. In certain surgical procedure, they apply carbon dioxide. In certain, they apply nitrous oxide. I think nitrous oxide gas also applied in anesthesia. So these are the helium, ethylene. These all are applied in different type of surgical procedure. So these cylinders have various code because otherwise they can be mixed with each other. So with these colors, you can differentiate these type of these are cylinders. There are gases cylinder over there. You can see that because in smaller hospitals they can apply on the basis of these cylinders. But if big hospital, there's this consumption is more than that, so you cannot handle with the help of these cylinders. What you have to do? They go for big VI tanks. You may have seen VI tanks over there. You may have seen these are liquid oxygen. Mostly it is liquid oxygen is there. So they are big oxygen tanks are available. You can say because if there's a number of patients has been increased and they are on oxygen or whatever various type of gases, so they cannot handle because the consumption is increased more and more. So what happens in big hospitals, they have installed various type of big cylinders. So they are known as VIE tanks. VIE, you can find the abbreviation of VIE tank because they have a special pressurized instrument attached over there. That can supply these gases to various wards and units. We now understand that they have various cylinders, gases, then they have VIE tanks. They have different size of that, up to various type of, they have different size of liquid tanks are available. So they are installed according to the capacity of, or the consumption of each hospital, they are installed over there. So now.
Hello, sir.
हाँ जी मैं आप अब इसके बाद आपको बताऊंगा जब अगली क्लास में we'll discuss one by one.
Okay.
ठीक है now we're recording that one so in the next class we'll discuss one by one. So what are public procurement rules? Now, these all things which are purchased in hospitals, they are supported, they are based on public procurement rules. You can't purchase because at your home you can purchase whatever you want. You go in a market and you can purchase. But in a hospital, public hospital, government hospital, whether it is the provincial or to the federal level, the procurement is based upon certain type of rules. You can't deviate the rules. So what is the public procurement rule is that public is broadly defined as the purchasing, hiring, obtaining, any other contractual means of goods, construction, whatever is this. So these are rules which covers all these things which are purchased in a public hospital or public department, government department. So they are supported on the basis of public procurement on these, whatever purchase is supported on the basis of these public procurement rules. Now public rule is, what's the public procurement? Defined as the purchase of commodities and contracting of construction works and services if such acquisition is affected with resources. Now the resources from state budget. Now public procurement is based on the state government budget or local authority budgets, state foundation funds, domestic loans or foreign loans guaranteed by the state, foreign aid, as well as revenue received from the economic activity of state. So the government budget, state budget means government budgets, or the local area budget, local administration budget. So those procurement which is done through for government hospital is based on the budget which is given by the state. So these are covered under the public procurement, the budgets which is given by the government, as whatever it is, these are public procurement. Then what the public procurement means? Acquisition of goods, services, or construction of any works financed wholly or partly out of the public fund. So funds including projects or public-private partnership unless excluded otherwise. So the procurement through government funded. Procurement through government funded is known as a public procurement. Further, you can say that what's the meaning of goods? Goods means articles and objects of every kind and descriptions, including what you are going to purchase, raw materials, drug and medicines, products, equipments, machinery, spare parts, commodities, in any forms, including solid, liquid, gaseous form, and includes services identical to installations, transport, maintenance, similar obligations related to the supply of goods, if the value of these services does not exceed the value of such goods. So what are goods mean? Whatever going to purchase in a hospital or in a government function is known as a goods. We further give. So what we have to do in last lecture, what the initiates order, new item, what are they're going to purchase, what is the demand? First, what they generate a demand, what is the requirement of a hospital or government function is that if they're going to erect a new building, they have to initiate its demand over there. Now there are two types of budgets over there, development schemes and non-development budgets. One is a development, because in certain hospitals they have added a new wards, they have added a new equipments, as actually biomedical equipments are very costly. So for such they have to introduce development scheme. They have introduced development scheme that go from development budget, because these biomedical equipments are cost in millions. So for that they have a separate budget. So that is known as development schemes or development budgets. And non-development budget, in which the routine items which are already purchased, there's drug medicine they were purchasing, so they have a different budgets. For that chemicals or their laboratory which are routine are purchased, they every year the government has give a sanction. They have introduced these budgets. So that is a normal budget. That's a non-development budget, a routine budget on the basis of that hospital has to be run. So that initially they have given by the provincial or federal government. Now what actually priority procurement, what they have to do? Actually the development schemes, project, prepare, what they were, they have to prepare PC1. They have PC1 and PC2. Then approval of PC1 and PC2 from company authority. PC1 is Planning Commission 1. PC1 stands for Planning Commission 1 and PC1. Approval of PC1 and PC2 from competent forum. Issuance of administration approval. Then technical sanction of detailed estimates. Placement of funds with executing agency. Site possession or land, whatever is required in that PC1, they have to prepare according to that. So what is the procurement planning? Mandatory provision of procurement plan. All procurement agencies shall devise a mechanism for planning in detail for all proposed procurement, determining the requirement of the procurement agency within its available resources, and prepare an annual or a longer term rolling plan detailing the procurement methods applicable for specific. So what happens when they receive a budget? After the budget allocation, after every year, when they receive a budget allocation, they prepare procurement plan according to that. Because when they receive that amount, that such organization or such hubs have such amount of budget, according to that, they have to plan a procurement plan, what they are going to purchase, whether if they are big equipments, so they have planned according to that. The routine equipment, they have to materials or articles, they have to garden. So for a whole year, for a full year, they plan according to budget allocation. So that is known as a procurement plan. The annual procurement, similarly, they also go for annual procurement plan. New item statements, which shows the object, code, commitment, item, budget, estimate. The planning development shall initiate working on annual procurement plan. So I told you the, what has to procure the whole year from 1st July to 30th June of that fiscal year. They have to plan that in which month, which things are they are going to be purchased. So what they are going to plan, annual procurement plan. It consists of following: preparation of bidding documents and approval from competent authority through procurement committee, tender schedule, date of selling of documents, closing date of tender, tender. So what they are in that plan? Because they have to first according to annual plan, because these all has to be tenders, they have to go for tender. So every thing which is going to purchase, they give a tender schedule when they are going to float the tender. So date of selling of documents, because they have to sell different type of documents when they're going to float a tender. Then it's closing date of tender. Then when they're going to open the tender. So these have to be prepared in that plan of that one. Then they also give technical bids, evolution of date, commercial bids, opening date, technical bids, evolution dates. They have to also be technical, what type of specification that was required. They are also prepared technical bids. Then they evaluate these technical bids. Then similarly, they're the commercial bids. Then they are opening tenders. I think we'll stop up to this. So we'll